Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to GPG 27 in Voorhees, New Jersey. I'm your host for the evening, Adam Christ, alongside, as always, my verbal sparring partner for the evening, Jackson Galka. Jackson, we have a steady night of fights tonight, some titles on the line. Tell us a little bit about our main event for the evening, Jackson.
Main event, Deshaun Boatwright taking on Eric Ellerby. These are two of the best 200-plus pound guys on the East Coast, and they're going to collide right in the center, so I don't see this one going out of the first round.
GPG 27 action, we are ready to get underway.
My name is Eric Ellerby. Where I'm from is Baltimore, Maryland. I train at Senior Ray Dojo. On average, I train about 6 hours a week there. I like training at Senior Ray because it's a lot of different techniques that you don't see every day. Competitive. And you always have guys coming in wanting to challenge you, so it's good competition. What I like about GPG is that they are a high-class organization, all about true martial arts, respect, and competition at its highest level. Me winning is just a step closer to my ultimate goal. I want to be known as one of the great martial artists in the world, and this is one step towards that goal.
My name is Deshaun Boatwright, aka Buck the 400-pound silverback from Richmond, VA. Man, I love training in Mans 2 Richmond. We have the biggest, baddest killers this side of the United States. So far, what I've seen from the global proving ground, they are professional, they are courteous, they are about the skills and the safety of the fighters. So I'm excited to be fighting for them. I would be nowhere without my fans. My fans, they give me motivation. My family gives me motivation. My friends give me motivation to train. Because, you know, working, you know, 40 plus hours a week and then training, you know, 15, 20 hours a week, it can wear on you. But when you got people cheering you on, it means the world to me. So I'm going out there, I'm doing it for them, I'm gonna bring this belt home.
Next up is our co-main event. We have Deshaun Boatwright taking on Eric Ellerby for the GPG title.
And now for our co-main event of the evening. The referee for this fight is Bill Bookwalter. And this is sponsored by Black Rifle Coffee Company and Batteries Plus Bulbs. First up, we have a 34-year-old with a 2-0 professional MMA record. He stands at 6 foot tall and weighs 207 official pounds. He represents MMA Institute of Richmond, Virginia. In the blue corner, Deshaun Buck, the 400-pound silverback boat ride. And his opponent is a 32-year-old with a 1-2 pro MMA record. He stands at 6'3" and weighs 208 pounds. He represents Senior A Dojo out of Baltimore, Maryland. In the red corner, Eric Ellerby. This is our light heavyweight championship for this belt, folks. Hold on tightly to your seats.
President and CEO James Jefferson exiting the cage in front of Stephen Peacock as we prepare for our co-main event of the evening. Deshaun Boatwright taking on Eric Ellerby at 205 pounds.
One fighter looking to take home some hardware tonight as this is for the light heavyweight championship. Here we go. Deshaun Boatwright taking on Eric Ellerby.
Deshaun leading with the right foot. You often see, you know, oftentimes these wrestling guys that transition over from wrestling, In, you know, if you're right-handed, you'll lead with your right foot in wrestling, but in striking, you would lead with your left. Mm. And so, you know, Rick McCoy, very sensitive to that, is teaching these guys how to fight southpaw, their natural stance from wrestling, and makes for some great transitions here. Boatwright with a big takedown right at the beginning of the first round. Ellerby recovering guard. And here we go. We'll see what both these fighters have on the ground.
You know, Jackson, a lot of times with the bigger guys, they take their time. They feel each other out. These guys didn't waste any time, started coming out firing, and then the big takedown, like you said. And let's see what happens in this light heavyweight championship action.
Boatwright very dominant in his takedown attempt, but seems to be a little bit too comfortable inside the guard. And that can get you into trouble if you're dealing with a guy that's got a couple tricks up his sleeve. And so, you know, this is not a place you want to be. You want to be past the guard. You want to eliminate their ability to threaten you with anything. Establish your position and then start raining downhill. Nice knee slice from Deshaun, cutting all the way across to side control. Ellerby holding on for dear life, it seems, as Deshaun locks up that far side underhook, keeping Ellerby flat on the mat. From our angle, difficult to tell, but it looks like Boatwright has secured the crucifix position, which has tied up both of Ellerby's arms, making it very difficult for him to defend the short punches here that are raining down.
Now, Jackson, you're wise. If you were Eric Ellerby in such a disadvantageous position right now, what do you need to do? He's not active. He's not doing much. What do you need to do to get back in this contest?
This is a really tough position to defend. I mean, it's sort of like the best defense to the crucifix is just not to get stuck in it in the first place. But you'll notice that Ellerby's right arm is draping over the back of Boatwright's neck. He needs to frame out with that forearm underneath Boatwright's neck, create some space, readjust his hips. He's going to have an easier time being effective with his right arm rather than his left arm, the one that's trapped under the leg. And he's just a sitting duck here for whatever Deshaun wants to.
Bill Bookwalter's right on top of the action.
There's a Americana attempt here from Boatwright. Hard to tell if he's going to be successful. You really got to pull the elbow down towards the ribs, and it looks like, you know, Boatwright's really cranking hard on the arm, but he's got to pull that elbow back down towards the ribs.
Now with the arm trap, firing down with the elbows, the short shots, but they accumulate. Referee scrambles.
Referees are very sensitive to that position. You know, fights can be won or lost there very easily. But Boatwright just wasn't aggressive enough. You know, wasn't threatening enough with the strikes to really make it happen.
Bill Bookwalter called a stop to the contest so Eric Ellerby can replace his mouthpiece.
It's really tough to, you know, especially if you're a guy like Boatwright, you're on top, you got a great position. These restarts can really throw you off your rhythm and give your opponent an opportunity to really buck and escape and explode because you haven't really settled all the way back in. So
fighters resume their position.
Good. Ellerby kind of missing his one chance to really just explode and catch Boatwright off guard. Boatwright, he's doing a pretty good job of staying on top. Ellerby making it tricky for him, but isn't really threatening with anything sound, if that makes sense. He's surviving, but not really threatening with anything sound. You got the silverback gorilla on top of you. You really got to come correct with your grappling defense.
And Deshaun's going back and forth, threatening with different positions on the head and different positions on the arm, then firing down shots, keeping Eric Ellerby confused. Doing a great job on top, Boatwright is, though.
And the opportunity to cause a little bit more damage is there. Mm. He's not for just grinding away.
It's definitely scoring points.
This is exhausting when you got a 205-pound monster just driving all their weight into you. It's just takes a lot out of you. So the onus right now on Ellerby to make something happen as Boatwright can just sort of coast his way through to the end of the round here.
Now Boatwright has the back.
Hit the you can really tell the difference between a jiu-jitsu guy and a wrestler, right? A wrestler would sort of stay on the back the way that Boatwright is and strike, whereas a jiu-jitsu guy would be locking those.
Whoa!
Wow. Big suplex there.
Closing seconds of this fight, or the first round of this fight, and big, big suplex from the silver back, Deshaun Boatwright.
Shave your head. Reach for the Headblade Moto. Designed and crafted with the sleek precision of a MotoGP, the all-new Headblade actually leans into turns for the smoothest head shave ever. The front rollerball creates a unique dual-action suspension that hugs the curves and pulls ahead in the straightaways. The pain of shaving is now a joyride. Headblade Moto. Available now online at Headblade.com and at your local Walgreens.
Eric Ellerby, what would you be telling him going into the second round?
You got to circle. You don't want to be flat-footed and directly in front of a guy who wants to take you down. You know, if your heels are dug into the mat, you're standing directly in front of him, you are prime target for that blast double. So Ellerby needs to pump that jab, keep moving laterally, and stay one step ahead. It's a tall order. You know, it's a difficult way to win a fight, but at this level, you need to be able to do that. And so Ellerby, you know, has the advantage here as a southpaw, has the striking advantage. But, you know, maybe being a little bit too aggressive on his feet is getting him into these clinch situations, which is kind of the opposite of what he wants. This is exactly Boatwright's bread and butter stuff. Just get you to the ground, maul you a little bit, and, you know, you survive by the skin of your teeth.
Yeah, starting the second round, Ellerby let his hands go, and that was just enough for Boatwright to slip underneath, switch levels, and get Ellerby back to the ground. Smart game plan. Ellerby back to his feet, but the silverback Boatwright is firing some shots.
They're not the best-looking punches, but based on the way Ellerby is reacting to him, there's a lot of power behind those short punches.
Switching from the knees to the punches, and Ellerby's not doing much to defend this. Bookwalter right on top of the action.
Ellerby with a nice short spinning elbow, though. I got to give it to him. That was smart and kind of reverse momentum. Big knee to the head here from Ellerby. He's still very much in this fight.
Yeah. Wasn't defending himself much, but bounces back and firing some shots of his own.
Boatwright taking a moment to sort of recover his composure, catch his breath, look for a big explosive attempt at a takedown here from, and I will eat my words there, a gentle ankle pick. Same end game there.
Got him down briefly. Ellerby back to his feet. Again, Boatwright peppering him with some shots. There you go. You just called your shot a little early, but boom.
I was a little late, yeah. But, Boatwright landing inside control. Very close to taking the back. Ellerby's got to be careful. That sort of bully choke. It's a big gamble. Mm. We call the schoolyard headlock there. Big gamble, as you often lose your position. Boatwright a little overeager on that attempt and almost gets his back taken, but you just see that scrambling ability of Boatwright there is on another level.
Yeah, it was a solid scramble. Ellerby looked like he was going to gain position. Solid scramble, and now it's Boatwright back on top. Boatwright firing some short shots.
Boatwright's very close to taking the mount position here. Very hard to see from this angle. Looks like he's stuck in quarter. Both knees are on the mat. He's still trapped. Allerby needs to get his hips out to his right. Now as long as he's flat on his back, he's like acting as if he's a table for Boatwright's weight. And what you want to do is you want to tip that table so that it's very difficult to rest any weight on it. You know, you can imagine putting a glass of water on a slanted table, it slides right off. Gravity's, you know, working not in favor of the glass of water. And so right now when Ellerby's flat on his back here, he's just carrying the weight. And again, that's exhausting. Deshaun could just coast through this.
Referee Bill Bulkwalter's calling for more action.
Really, the last thing you want to be doing is grabbing the head and pulling down. All you're doing is just pulling his weight on top of you. And it's a good stalling technique. Mm. You know, it's preventing Boatwright from really creating a ton of damage, but it's not advancing his position. And as long as he's on his back like this, he's losing the match. You know, he's going to find himself in a third round where he needs that Hail Mary punch or kick to finish the fight. And that's not a place you want to be.
Yeah, Deshaun Boatwright's done a fantastic time riding this guy out. But Bill Bulkwalter's seen enough, calls both fighters to their feet, both fighters center cage, to close down this round.
Big right hand from Boatwright that just misses, but had every ounce of his 205 pounds on it.
Ellerby firing some knees. Solid second round. Deshaun Boatwright, Eric Ellerby. Good light heavyweight action.
Global Proving Ground is sponsored by Barb's Harley-Davidson, Black Rifle Coffee Company, We Hate Mondays, Headblade, the ultimate head shaving razor, and G Fuel, fuel your life.
I understand having a preferred style, but it is mixed martial arts. If you can't mix it up,
you know, and it really favors the grappler. And one thing you'll see is that your striking can only be as strong as your grappling. If your grappling's not very strong, your striking can't be very strong because of the threat of the takedown and all the groundwork that happens.
And just like that, Boatwright doesn't waste any time getting this contest to the mat. Ellerby started the third round pretty strong, but coming forward, Boatwright was able to duck underneath, get it to the ground. Again, firing some shots. Against Ellerby against the cage. Back to the ground they go with Boatwright getting the takedown.
Yeah, Boatwright is an expert at controlling the position of this fight, you know, dictating where the fight's going. Could use a little bit of work on his finishing ability, you know, whether it's his submissions or his strikes, but overall just a very, very solid and very dominant performance from the MMA Institute prospect who looks to be coasting to a 3-0 career here as we approach the end of this fight in the third round. Still plenty of time for Eric Ellerby to mount some sort of comeback, but given what we've seen so far, I'm not sure where it's going to come from. If Boatwright's not giving him any space, there's no opportunity there.
Needless to say, Ellerby's going to need a stoppage this round in order to win this contest.
Boatwright's, you know, starting to change it up a little bit, posturing up, creating some space on the ground so he can fill it with his strikes. And that's kind of what you want to see. Kind of the best situation you want to be in. Got your opponent pinned up against the cage right in front of your coach.
Yeah.
You guys can sort of collaborate on how you want to break this guy down. It needs to create space. Get those feet on the hips. Push, drive, shrimp, squirm, whatever it takes. Get back to his feet and just throw everything at Boatwright because, you know, at this rate, as we said, it's just case closed.
At this point, Ellerby's not doing much to defend himself. It's just kind of okay with laying there. I mean, obviously a fight takes a lot out of you. I'm just wondering if he's exasperated or flustered.
He's tough, and he's got you know, great grit, but he just lacks the skill set. Mm. You know, that's what it is. It's not a lack of athleticism or drive or heart. It's lacking the skill set to contend with a guy who's got so much grappling experience like Deshaun Boatwright. And this is exactly what Ellerby needs. He's got Boatwright's a little bit tired. And, you know, that's there for Ellerby to just start to.
You can see Ellerby's mouth is wide open. This contest is definitely taking its toll on him.
Yeah, it's tough getting tag teamed by, you know, not just your opponent, but also the forces of gravity for 15 minutes. You know, it's very much like a two-on-one scenario where you're just carrying your opponent's weight as they're beating you up. It's no fun. Ellerby, certain sort of unteachable qualities, grit, heart, toughness. These are all things that he possesses. He just needs to refine it with a little bit more technique, a little more mixed martial arts technique.
Yeah, I'd like to see a little more striking out of Boatwright. Obviously, we've seen his ground game. We've seen his clinch work. But, you know, if it wins a fight, it wins a fight. But I'd definitely like to see a little bit of his stand-up techniques.
Yeah, it's tough. You know, 3-0, 4-0, 5-0, at some point you're going to fight a guy that you can't take down.
Yeah.
You know, as you get into the upper echelons of the sport, now you're not going to just bulldoze your way through everybody. And you may have to win a fight with some of your auxiliary techniques, like your striking, if that's not your first love or whatever. And, you know, we'll see if Deshaun has those skills, but he just defaults so often back to this heavy top pressure that, you know, hopefully it doesn't become like a one-trick pony.
Mm.
But so far, fought three people, and all three people haven't had an answer for him for what the table ain't broke.
It kind of gives a blueprint for future opponents, but right now it's looking like he's going to coast to 3-0. And again, like you said, if it's not broke, don't fix it.
You know, and it's a very simple answer, a very, very simple answer strategically to a guy like Boatwright. You know, stay long, circle on your feet, sprawl and brawl. Very simple. It doesn't make it easy. It's very difficult, but it's very simple. It's a simple game plan. You just need to have the skills to execute it.
Probably won the championship round. Was taking a close look at Eric Ellerby, talked to the referee, Bill Bookwalter. It's looking like Bookwalter saying he's okay, or giving his opinion anyway.
We are seconds
going into
out
the
here.
Championship rounds, round four.
Seconds out here. From round number four. And this is a great experience for both guys. I mean, to get five rounds under your belt kind of makes three rounds a piece of cake. But
Boatwright fakes the takedown. Again, comes over top and then presses Ellerby against the cage.
You know, accuracy on your strikes is tough when you're rushing forward like that.
Yeah.
Maybe a more measured approach would lend itself to better accuracy there for Boatwright, but this is exactly what he wants. He wants to turn it into just a mauling.
Excellent performance thus far by Deshaun Boatwright, dictating the pace, fighting his fight, doing what he needs, you know, to win the fight thus far. May not be the prettiest for people, but again, like you said, if it's not broke, don't fix it. And doing a great job dominating this contest against Eric Ellerby for the GPG light heavyweight title.
There's no question here, Boatwright carries a ton of power in that frame. And if he can learn to channel that into, you know, channel that into crisp, accurate striking, his opponents are going to have a hell of a time staying on their feet, you know, not getting knocked out. But right now, going back to his bread and butter, all the wrestling, the grappling, it's working very well for him.
Another thing I'm curious about, Jackson, like I said, I'd like to see a little bit more from Boatwright standing, but I'm also eager. He hasn't taken much damage in this fight. I'm wondering how he can actually absorb shots if it does come his way. Obviously, it hasn't happened much this fight, as he's fought his fight, made a lot of clinch work and taken down, but I wonder about his chin.
You know, and that's tough. When you're... it's very difficult to want to put yourself in situations in practice where you get beat up, to train to your weaknesses. It's just very, very difficult. And so for a guy, when you're big, you're powerful, and you got world-class grappling, it's very easy to get yourself into safe positions in training. So, you know, who knows what kind of grit a guy like Boatwright has when it comes to taking damage. It's hard to say.
Boatwright with a nice trip. Again, getting the fight where he wants.
Boatwright was very, very accomplished in his wrestling, but very raw in his submission attacks here, and that's an easy fix. It's a quick fix. You know, could take his fights from five rounds to five minutes maybe. And I notice here, perfect opportunity to get those hooks in. He opts for wrestling control from the back. It's just a little bit less reliable.
Working for him thus far this fight, but again, in the future, we'll see how that that holds up.
Referee Buchwalder restarting or pausing the fight here to reinsert LRB's mouthpiece for the second time. I do believe that maybe one of those three strikes and you're out type things.
Yeah.
At best, you lose a point, which, you know, could change the course of a fight. In this case, probably not. At worst, disqualified. Again, the name of the game here is
Boatwright.
Intelligent defense.
And Bill Buchwalter calls a stop to the contest. TKO victory for Deshaun Buck, the 400-pound silverback Boatwright. Dominant performance from Boatwright. Oh, my goodness gracious. Gorgeous. Just ragdolled Eric Ellerby around the cage. Up until round four, until he got the stoppage, Deshaun Boatwright, the new GPG light heavyweight champion.
LRB putting up a little bit of a protest on that stoppage, but Adam, I mean, he took a lot of damage and really didn't have a lot to offer offensively in those four rounds. And so good call by our good friend Bill Buchwalter here. I mean, the name of the game is keeping these guys safe. You know, the onus is on the fighter to protect themselves at all times and defend themselves intelligently. And sort of the key word there being intelligently, Adam, is LRB was just sort of surviving that onslaught and not really intelligently defending himself, leading Buchwalter to stop rightly the fight here in the fourth round.
Yeah, I can't blame the stoppage there. Let's throw it up to our ring announcer, Stephen Peacock.
This bout is stopped at 3 minutes and 19 seconds of the fourth round. The winner by referee stoppage, TKO, came out of the blue corner. Deshaun Buck, the 400-pound silverback Boatwright.
And that concludes our evening here at GPG 27 here at Voorhees, New Jersey at the Coliseum Fight Club. Excellent night of grappling matches, excellent night of fights, some new hardware exchange. Some people are going home with new titles. Great night of fights for sure. Great night in the GPG cage. That'll wrap it up for this evening. Thank you as all for tuning in. I'm your host, Adam Christ, alongside, as always, my verbal sparring partner for the evening, Jackson Galka. Join us next time for more GPG action.